guys! Welcome to chaos. I'm just kidding. I'm not chaos. I'm feeling a little chaotic right now, but I'm not going to take on that feeling as a personality trait today. Hi! I have filmed this intro like 4 times now, and I'm upset that it just hasn't been looking good and feeling good. I basically am trying to tell you guys to wrap up nicely in a bow the fact that I have not posted a vlog in like a month, and it was good that I hadn't. It was time that I needed separate from my camera, separate from posting on the internet. That has been very good for me. I have good news and I have bad news to announce. The good news is that earlier this year I was casted in a Canon commercial, and I put a link down at the about section of this video for you to see. And they featured me as a content creator and a vlogger, which was so exciting and such a fun job to be a part of. I also posted it on my Instagram. And around the time I posted it on my Instagram, like the same day, my camera broke, which is also another reason why I stopped vlogging. I have a new camera now. We welcome her. Thank you to Canon USA for gifting me this camera. What else? Another good news thing is that last week I was in a campaign for Lululemon. Yes, Lululemon, little old me for Lululemon. And that's something, this is like the first place that I'm announcing this. I haven't even shared it on my Instagram. And that was last week, and I basically was with them for 4 days modeling, and it was crazy. It was crazy. And I did an entire vlog. I like filmed a ton on my phone the whole time, so I think I'm gonna turn that into a video that will come out in April at some point when I'm allowed to like share what clothes I was wearing and stuff. So stay tuned for that. Honestly, that's extremely exciting. And then, What else? Oh, I also just now, like last week, got a car, which is a crazy stressful thing to work out. So much waiting and so much nervousness, and I freaking so awkward talking to people about your financial state as a 26-year-old. It's super awkward. Prayers up, because I test drove and I'm obsessed with the car. I basically sold my car that I had in Florida when I was in high school. I gave my sister back her car because I had been borrowing it for the past 2 months, and I bought a car. I did all of those things within 1 week of deciding that I was going to do it, and it was chaotic and it was crazy, and so many things have happened this month and I feel accomplished, but it was really stressful. It was very, very stressful. Another thing that was stressful to deal with is that I'm okay, but I haven't felt like myself for a while, and I think a part of it is the fact that it's been super rainy in LA. It feels like every time I'm like, oh, the sun's back, the next day it's raining, and then it's raining for 5 days straight, and then the sun is back, and then it's rainy again, and that's really been throwing me off, I won't lie. One of the reasons that I moved to LA was because it's so sunny, and I'm like tired of the weather affecting my mood so much, so that's a thing I've been going through. Okay, trying to think of what else is... Oh, okay, another thing to share is that a beautiful thing to share is that over the last 2 months, my relationship to God has been revived. It feels like ever since I shared on my Q&A video that I was kind of struggling in being a Christian, considering myself a Christian, walking with God, hanging out with Christians, etc., etc. Ever since then, it feels like my life and my heart had opened up to exploring that part of me and that part of my life that's always been very important to me. And so that's something that's new and has been such a great source of peace for the past 2 months, is like I feel solid in my relationship to God again, and that's been keeping me that's been keeping me together when life wants me to fall apart, you know what I'm saying? So that's new and fun, and I think I'm going to start talking more about God in my vlogs. I know that people have trauma with God. I had trauma with God. I still have trauma with God. I have trauma with the church. I have trauma with religion in general. But at the end of the day, it's like, oh, God is so special to me. Like, believing in Jesus has been something that's changed my life over the past 8 years, and yeah, that's just a part of me, so that's something I'm going to start sharing more of on the vlog, and yeah. Okay, thank you for being here. Let's roll the tape. Roll the tape, because I'm tired of talking today. Okay, enjoy. Good morning, guys.
I won't lie, I'm not feeling too hot. I have these pimple stickers all over my face because for the last 4 days, I've been modeling shooting with Lululemon, and it was the best experience of my life, but I think that I'm not okay now. Only thing keeping me is that today I'm going to go pick up my new car, which I'm so excited, and I'm gonna bring you guys along with me. I went last week to go look at this car. I didn't actually think that I would get it. I didn't think that they would approve me, honestly, and I was nervous. I was nervous to go to a car dealership, but I found out I was approved for the car. I put the down payment on. It's been a week of waiting because I had my shoot. I couldn't go pick it up any earlier, and today's the day. It's a beautiful day to go get a car.
So excited.
Okay, I got the car keys. It's crazy being in this dealership and not being filled with stress and anxiety because now I have a car. I'm so grateful and I'm so excited. Here we go. Okay guys, I won't even lie. I've been, the drive to pick up my car and now sitting in it, the entire time I've been sitting here, like, I am actually in disbelief. I feel so taken care of. I don't know how to explain this, mainly because I'm so freaking tired. I have wanted this specific car for years, and moving here, I just have literally been so, like, I'm not thinking about getting a car because the concept stressed me out so freaking much. I was just like, I feel like I'm so picky. I'm not gonna find the car that I want. I'm not gonna find the car that I like. I'm just not going to find it, and then I'm sure when I find it, I'm not gonna get approved. Like, these are things that I really was like thinking about and fearing, and when I found this car, I was like, okay, God, like, I'm only test driving this because it's the only model I've been able to find that, like, is in my price range, the color, like, way that I want, good mileage, etc. When I tell you this car is beyond perfect for me, like, when I test drove it, I was, like, not even taking pictures of it because I was like, I think this is a little too nice. Like, I'm 26. I just moved to LA. Like, I don't need something this nice. I really don't. And now driving it, I'm even more shocked because I'm like, this is perfect. Life has been a little bit crazy and rough, guys. It's been crazy and rough, and this just feels like we've gotten over the mound. We got over the hill. We got over the mountain. Okay, bye. I'm going to a coffee shop. Here's my sister. Yeah, it looks so good.
It's so high tech.
Yeah. Bianca.
Just
flip it like this. Oh, hey. I'm Bijit. That's Bianca's. Oh, it's out of it. We're at coffee right now. I didn't know where to look. Oh, hey. We're at coffee. I had matcha. Not a fan. Sorry.
It was a good matcha, too.
She's not a matcha drinker. It tastes like grass.
It does, but you get used to it.
Tell the people, what's it like being my older sister? Oh, why are you shaking your head?
I gotta play a lot.
I'm scared. Oh. So you don't cuss her out. I'm on my way back to LA, and I'm so tired. I was trying to sit there with my sister, trying to get some work done. No, wasn't happening. So we're driving back and I'm stuck in traffic. Sweet. I'm so back in a Lauryn Hill phase in my life right now. Like, she is queen. She's queen, and she is like a poetic queen. I just feel like any feeling you've ever felt, Lauryn Hill has sung about it in a song, 100%. Okay guys, so this new car, driving a new car is a little bit scary because it's so like, I don't know what's going on here. Like, I feel like I should have done my research before, like when I bought the car, And then over the past week, I should have been doing research of like, what does this mean? And what does this mean? Because I've been driving and I've just been so scared. I've been driving with sport mode on because I'm like, let's just have some fun. And I'm like, maybe not the best idea. I was thinking as I was driving, I feel like a lot has been happening in my life lately that doesn't really make any sense. And I just wanted to bring it up. I wanted to talk about it because I get, some people ask me like, what do you do for work? Or like I told my sister today, I was like, oh, I'm working on something for Aritzia right now. And she's like, how did you get that? I'm like, oh, they just like emailed me. And she's like, what? Like, how do these people find you? And I feel like that's a question I should answer. And not that I have many answers for that question, but I feel like I get really amazing opportunities compared to other content creators my size. And I'm honestly not sure what that's about. I'm super grateful for it, obviously, but I feel like it's sometimes hard to translate to people like, oh, this is what I'm working on, without feeling so stupid. Because like, even for example, the Canon commercial was crazy because I was like, I have no idea why you guys chose me. I literally don't know. And also it's kind of awkward and embarrassing that like, I was featured as a content creator and a vlogger, but I only have like 1,000 subscribers. You know, like, it's definitely kept me quite humble because I'm just like, it's like awkward. It's awkward to get opportunity off of something that like you don't really have that high of numbers with. And I don't know, I just wanted to just put that out there. Like, I know it's very weird to me too, but I think that it's very much God. But if I knew someone else who was in the same situation as me, I'd be like, what is up with that girl? Like, what is she doing? Is she a nepo baby? And no, I'm not. I'm not a nepo baby. Friggin' wish I was. Oh, look at the mountains. They're so beautiful.
Guys, I'm obsessed with this camera. It's so easy to use. Thank God. My other camera was also Canon. It was a G7X and it was great. But I feel like this one being a little bit bulkier is nice because I just feel like it's so much, it's like easier to use, so light, not an ad. I love Canon products, this is not an ad, but also like everything is so clear and crisp. Shout out to Canon, I love them. I just got home. I feel like I have this many brain cells, I won't lie. I'm so grateful to be home, I'm so grateful to have free time. I'm looking at these beautiful poppies and I'm like, that's a positive of the rain. Look at these guys, they're getting so long. Like, look at these beauties. Look at this long thing, it's coming from all the way over here. The rain has made them so much bigger, it's awesome. And there's my little lavender. Oh, and here's the construction that's been outside of my window for the past 3 weeks, in case you guys missed it, which you did. Good morning, sunshine. The earth says hello. Good morning, guys. It's Saturday, 8 a.m., and I feel, I needed sleep. I needed sleep so bad. Daylight savings was last week, and it's still throwing me off, but I love that there is sunshine in my bedroom this early in the morning. It's so beautiful. Today I'm going to the beach. It was my friend's birthday last week, and we did not celebrate, so we're going to celebrate this weekend. And I'm so happy. It's 75, like the high of 75 today. Ow. This bikini is so cute. I got it from this brand, I think they're Australian. You Swim. Softest fabric. I'm trying to decide if I want to wear this though, because I would wear this to hot yoga. Like, this is so cute, but I don't know about the shorts. But I think I'm gonna wear an actual bikini today, but I wanted to try this on because I got this and I hadn't opened it from the box yet. It's like funny going to the beach in the middle of winter because it's like, it's warm, but it's not really. So it always takes me a while to figure out what I'm wearing, but I think I'm gonna wear an actual bikini. But this is actually what I'm gonna wear. Thank you. smile. Look who's back. Look who's back alive. I woke up this morning like fist, what's it called? Fist pumping? because I feel like myself again. Everybody say amen, amen. After so many tired days and just feeling down. And not only that, but I feel like my heart has been growing so much, and a part of it is like the fact that my relationship to God is growing again and like becoming something so new and beautiful. Not that it ever stopped, I just think that I'm like finally not relating to God out of a place of fear or like nervousness or hesitation because of the trauma that I've been through in the Christian church. I just feel so like welcomed and like hugged by God and invited by Him to experience Him in new ways. And it's just crazy because I can feel how much He's like healing me. I haven't been feeling this like deep sadness. I haven't been feeling this like nervousness of life not working out for me or not being taken care of. I haven't been feeling anxiety lately, and I have felt less lonely. And these are things that like are huge for me, like things that I've dealt with my entire adult life that I've been like, I don't know how to deal with this. And it's just crazy. I feel like God has been healing my heart. And I feel so soft, and I feel tender, and I feel like unafraid to see myself and to like be emotionally available to myself. I felt like really beautiful inside of my, inside of here. And I can feel how much it's transforming me and changing me, and it's really encouraging to see. And I think the biggest thing, the number one thing that I have been, I feel like, fighting for is my aversion to spending time alone with myself, to finding joy in solitude and like being with myself. And I know that my vlogs are like me by myself all the time. I think you guys see this like part of me that's very like happy with myself. And granted, every time that I do film myself alone and I am full of joy, I actually am. But I have very many alone moments where I'm like, I don't want to go to that coffee shop by myself. I don't really want to go to a museum by myself. I don't want to go out for a walk by myself. I don't wanna. And lately I've been like, wait, that sounds so fun. Like, let's go do that. Let's go have an adventure. I don't know where it came from. I just feel grateful. My life has felt like this beautiful garden out here. Thank you so much for watching this. Hopefully life keeps being abundant. Hopefully life keeps glowing up and growing up. Adios. Thank you for watching. Bye.